welcome back to another Cyberpunk 2077 gameplay part 24. I'm RobotGZ. Last time I traveled around and read and found I think most of the tarot cards, and then I read them. So let's continue. But before I continue, I have just two things to talk about. I do this before I start playing the game, because they're just usually talking in the game, and it's just like sometimes like I forget what I was saying. So the first thing is there's somewhat new Mountain Dew flavor out. It's called Mountain Dew Spark. Its flavor is raspberry lemonade. I tried it. It's good. It's better than ginger snapped. So and then the second thing is a few days ago I recently beat Scott Pilgrim versus the World, the game. Even though, I had to use cheats, but I still had fun and enjoyed the game. Now I'm just, unlocking the characters and seeing if there's additional, like, end scenes. So, anyways, let's go. I don't know why it is having a hard time. Oh, not yet. I still have to find the other tarot cards here. I have 10 more. There's one. Okay, so I can only do one. Okay. Oh, don't do that. So, just right of me. Oh yeah, okay. For some reason, I feel like playing Dokapon Kingdom. I don't know why. Maybe it's because, like, I'm watching a gameplay of it. Oh. So. Thank you. I might as well talk about that. I recently started learning how to be the imposter in Among Us. I figured out that, like, I don't have to, like, I don't have to lie. It's just, less, like, yeah, I don't have to lie. Like, I can still, like, tell the truth. So, but I still prefer, being a crewmate. But that's just my opinion. Oh yeah, sir. I don't have another motorcycle. Oops. I thought I... Oh.
I need you to steal a certain document, and it's urgent. Find the details attached.
Yeah, get type 3, objective, steal data from a computer. Location, Dickie Twister, corner of Congress and Gerald Street. Details. Oh wait, this is a gig, so it's not, yeah, it's not really important unless I need the money. Okay, I was gonna say, what my tire slot? It was here. It was like this when I left it. I swear, officer. High Priestess Day. The High Priestess. The High Priestess is a card of mystery. It shows how all our secrets hang by a delicate thread and the struggle between common sense and intuition. The High Priestess symbolizes the cold, calm waters as well as the mysteries hidden in their depths. I can only do that. Oh, that's right. Whatever, it's fine. Down we go. Right.
Sorry, I forgot to do the...
Oh, wow. Huh. So that's where their building is. So Miltech is one of the companies, and, it's not really spoilers, but, you do occasionally face them. It's just interesting to see that building. How far is it from there? Yeah, it's walking distance. Death. Death is the card of becoming. It signifies an imminent and difficult transition, the conclusion of one phase of life and the beginning of another. Inevitably, something gets lost during the transformation, but something else will rise to take its place. Here. The aperture requirement appears in red. It means your aperture level is not high enough for it. Oh crap. Sorry! Okay. Well, no one's coming after me, so that's good. Well, how am I supposed to say? It's fine. So it's just a flesh wound. Or CD grammar.
Justice
is a card of conflict resolution. It proclaims the need for order, to see through lies and deceit, and a return to the natural state of affairs. Justice implies a just sentence, but also due process. That's what I thought. Alright. It's not gonna let me do the thing. I'll just go over the fence like I did before. Back off, I take you away. Back off, I take you away. I know you were wrong. This is not where you belong. Sign here. Strength. Strength is the card of resilience. It is associated with determination, bravery, and eternal struggle. One must have dedication in order to overcome obstacles and reach one's goal. Strength is about physical prowess and spiritual fortitude, the power that must be unleashed to achieve the impossible. I need more tier parts. Do I need 6? Vehicle, it's over there. on, I need to check something here. Wheel of Fortune! The Wheel of Fortune means that changes come. Once Destiny it also is a game show. Once Destiny, it could turn out for the better or the worse. Yet it also bears the promise of new possibilities. The Wheel reminds us that nobody remains at the top forever. Also, that not every situation is hopeless. 5 more. Oh, right behind me. Literally right. Oh, okay. I don't know why the game slightly froze like that. Hold on, Robert Wilson.
Hey, Pete! You hear me?
Loud and clear, you don't need to yell. What's up?
Doing a little competition. Shoot, prizes and all. You know, over here with the range.
Yeah, that'd make sense.
Well, you in?
I didn't think big parties are your thing.
Yeah, well, it ain't a big one, but, you know, I'm low on heads. I bring in the clients. Attract them.
Good try selling iron straight from the factory. Skip the whole part where you tinker for hours on each little shooter.
V, my dignity, please.
Sorry, Wilson. Don't shoot for fun.
I can respect that. Well, see ya. See ya. See
ya around. It's not. It's a child? Really? For sure, it would be a gay. Alright, so permits. There we go. The Hermit. The Hermit is a card of self-imposed isolation. It represents an escape from the hustle and bustle of the city, a turning away from constant newness toward ye old ways. For the Hermit, solitude is the road to the sublime, a road that is taken not with great bounds and strides, but with small, concentrated steps. Motorcycle. It's like, wait, who's behind me? The star. The star is the card of hope. In the darkest of nights, there is a light that shines the path to home. The star is inspiration, motivation, and gives us strength to move forward. No. Three more. Here's one. This one's there. Don't really have. Oh, never mind. Really, literally one right behind me. Oh, beside. This one. Alright, that is going to be it for now, so tune in next time to Cyberpunk 2077 Gameplay Part 25. This is RobotGZ signing off. Bye.